Good morning, everybody. I am very happy to mention about the donation, the contribution made by all Royalists in New York and all the All Boys fraternity. They have given the fullest cooperation throughout the past years to Royal College, not in single or few projects, but many projects they have started, and now they are continuing with all their efforts to upgrade the standard of Royal College. So I am very happy to have all these donations to the Royal College. It's our prime duty to safeguard the good name of Royal College with all these contributions and donations made by all our Royalists. So it's our concern that all the present boys at Royal, they have given their fullest attention to make all these donations and contributions in a proper way, and they have to utilize all these things, and they have to groom as a very well balanced set of Royalists. So all these juniors, all the present Royalists, they are very concerned about their academic activities, extra activities. So once they display their talents, skills and all other abilities to the entire Royal fraternity, they have now run down with the college, and they have given number of contributions, and their cooperation, they have extended their cooperation support to the college. So these All Boys in New York, group of 60, they have organized a good project. They have initiated a good project, and now they have completed it very successful way, and now they are going to hand over that classrooms which were renovated to the highest level. So now they are about to hand over that project. After the completion, they are now about to hand over the all the classrooms to the college. So I am very happy as a principal, because we always try to keep the college very clean and neatful way. So all these classes, once we go around the classes, we can see a big difference comparing to other classes. They need to actually make all these classes like their age or their period of time which they have spent very peacefully and very happily in those classes. So they need to keep all the classes in one uniform way of having all the chairs, desk and the floor and roof, all these areas with very comfortable and very attractive way. So we have only one Royal College in Sri Lanka, but we have to keep all this environment, all the buildings to the highest level, because the look actually we have identified in the face of all these buildings, we can see that outlook and the standards of all these buildings are very, very important. Because no one can build again this kind of very solid and very wonderful buildings. So it's our prime duty to safeguard, protect all these valuable things, and we have to hand over to the next generation in a very beautiful way. So all the old boys, parents, students, they are held down in the college to make the entire environment in a very beautiful and very clean and green way. Honorable Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, one of our distinguished old boy and very good product of Royal College, he is there to open all these classrooms and hand over to the college. Assistance and cooperation of all the old boys, now we are always ready to keep these buildings in a very beautiful way, and we have to protect all the valuable things of all this institution.
So likewise, our boys in present Troll College, I think they have line up to protect and safeguard all these buildings and furniture and all the environment in a clean and green way. So when we walk in this way, I think we can have a very beautiful and very nice and wonderful future for these youngsters. So as principal, I am my main task, my main duty is to educate them to keep up all these good works forever, and we have to keep the environment very clean and green, and we have to have a good education at Crowell. We need to show others how we learn with all other activities, because we have a very balanced way of education. Then only we have to move forward as a good royalist. So all these royalists are renowned to have this education, and they will one day uplift the standard of Royal College and also, and they will move forward with all the ambitions and all the expectations of parents, all boys and all other well-wishers around us. So as principal, I am here to thank all the old boys, especially all boys in the group of 80 and all boys of New York. So they have given a wonderful example to all others. So all other old boys also will do something to protect the safeguard the good name of Royal College. So then the present boys also will walk according to their guidance and directions in the same pathway. So that's the way actually we have to move forward. I thank all the old boys, Honorable Prime Minister Ranveer Kumar Singh, one of the good products of Royal College, and Honorable Minister of Education, Akhil Viraj Kariwasam, and all other parliamentarians who are gracing this occasion with Honorable Prime Minister, and all the old boys of the group of 60s, and all the old boys of New York, and all other segment of the stable and very solid way of working towards the next events or next endeavors in their lifetime. So I thank all the people, all the old boys. Thank you.
Good morning to all. Today is a very significant day in the school calendar of Royal College. Today, this event of opening of the grade 11 renovated block by the group of 60 of Royal College and the all boys fraternity in New York. So we are very happy that this type of project is taking place at Royal College, and this cannot be possible unless the help we get from our all boys. Today indeed is a very great occasion where our Honorable Prime Minister, who is also one of the members of Group of 60 and today's chief guest, has come here to grace this occasion. We are very thankful to Honorable Prime Minister of the Group of 60 who have rendered the fullest cooperation to make this building renovated to a high class standard where they were students once. Today it's very sports and extracurricular activities. This group is really in need of advancing or improving the academic arena of Royal College. I'm thankful to the chairman, the secretary, and all the members of the Group of 60 for their unconditional help. Thank you very much, Group of 60, and also the old boys in New York who helped us in various ways. Finally, I would like to thank our Honorable Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe for gracing this occasion. Thank you very much.
get up on the phone.
Thank you.
Yeah.
and made us what we are.
scientific accomplished and leaving a legacy that 500 students are occupying the refurbished classrooms, learning in a safe and healthy environment, returned to their original glory. We hope that other alumni groups, Ken Palmer is seated there, will emulate us, enabling more students to share in this experience. Our wounds may be breathing, the hair may have fallen, our organs may be running on transplants, but our passion for Royal that made us what we are will never be forgotten. Thank you. If you look at the program, I now call upon Principal Sabira to say a few words.
Of this school and loyal citizens that have guided the destiny of
Madananda, standing in front of this historic gathering. We say that we will safeguard and uphold those traditions and standards, enabling world to produce many more leaders to assist our motherland in a marching to the future. Honorable Prime Minister, sir, I would be failing in my duty if I do not mention here the support and guidance you have extended to Royal College. We are as principal for the Royal College Union, as the representatives of the alumni, sought your assistance. You are readily available to help and guide us. We would have faced much more difficulties in the administration issues if not for your timely and precious interventions. On behalf of Royal College fraternity, I express our gratitude and appreciation for your kind assistance. Once again, thanking the Honorable Prime Minister and all other distinguished guests for taking time off their busy schedules to be part of this grand opening. I conclude, have a pleasant day, great. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Abhinandu. Now it is my unique privilege and honor to invite the Honorable One and Return Speaker, Prime Minister of Sri Lanka, and fellow Sikhi Group to address the Assembly.
Whether we achieve the high
Pandey invited is here in this hall, in the board prizer, starting with Turner Prize, named after James Turner, the translator of the Mahavansha, where we discovered our history, and the Indian discovered who was number one. When he died, the prize was awarded to his name. And if you look at the winners of those prizes, they were the first people who came modern Sri Lanka, beginning from Hail and the Torres down to Mayor. The country we live in wouldn't have been that if not for those scholars or those who won the Turner Prize and the senior mathematical. So this is the task that we have to keep continuing. Generation after generation. And that is currently the ultimate objective of anyone who has passed through the halls of this school. Sports, extracurricular activities, all those contribute to making us who we are. And how we contribute to that finality. So what we have done, I hope, will also be an example for some of the groups so that they could take to us the floor and do the same with them. I think there are some more floors that require to repair. And so many have been helping us financially and otherwise, but there is much more that can be done. So I hope this will be an example for the other past few years, and not only for old boys, but not only for old boys of Royal College, I think it is an example for the past few years. All schools. Because all schools in the past few years do make a big contribution to keeping the school going as a commander with the Kuriti Tanand, or whether it's Bagamu Central, they all make, and many have been in existence for more than 50 years. People have achieved different straight life, they have gone abroad, they have the money, so I think we should all be an example to help those schools. And then we can say our school is the best school. My colleague, the Minister of Education, now runs a program to the Ministry of Order towards the school is the best school. So I think parallel to that, without competing to that, we can add our work by saying our school is the best school. So that we also contribute differently. For me anyway, the closest school is Lawrence. I just step across the road, I don't know what the school that is. But these are different ways. We can educate the buildings in the government. But there's other work. So like say you work in signal is reminding of that. Adami Visheshema, Rajaki Vidyale, Bhattaya Purnagite, Udapatakwe, Pasaya. Thank you.
some presentation of plaques. There are two groups that provided us financial and other support other than the 60 group. And as I mentioned before, the biggest support came from the Sri Lankan Army. So on behalf of the 60 group, executive committee, we would like to present a special plaque which I brought all the way from New York in my hand, like it, so I'm eager to get rid of it, but for a good cause. It says, Royal College 1960-109 Group presents this award to the Sri Lankan Army in recognition of the outstanding contribution and service provided for the Royal College West Wing Classroom Restoration Project, presented by Honorable Ryan Wickremesinghe, Prime Minister and member of the 60 Group. So I call upon the Prime Minister to present this award to the Army. We now have a short PowerPoint presentation by my co-vice president of the 60 Group Redevelopment Committee, Dr. Mohan Kumar. Mohan, is all yours.
Grand Union, which was hosted by the Honorable Prime Minister for the on November 7th, at Pepper Trees, a lot of alumni from all over the world had gathered in Kalambu for this event. But Ajra organized a walkthrough for many of us. When we entered 1968, most of us left 1967, 1968. So it was 50 years later, we were going back for the first time. And we started in Form 1. Medicine like started in Form 1A, which is at the right at the end. And this is at the start of the walkthrough in the hall with the previous principal, Mr. Hunsekera. And this is what we saw. Broken windows and frames. Yes, all lighted. You can see gold on the walls, crumbling. Broken windows, broken and concrete on the floor, mold on the corridor, this right outside the old Form 1A, broken banister. So there was a problem there, severe deterioration of the West Wing. And as far as of us concerned, we thought having a safe learning environment is very and safe and healthy and pleasant environment is very, very important for the education process. If you ask a parent, why do you send your child to school? They will tell you, we want our child to have a good education. That means to learn their math, their sciences, their languages, history, and be productive citizens and be gainful employed. Everything else is called extracurricular activities, whether it be rugby, cricket, dance, club, band, whatever. They are good. We are not saying they are bad. There is a wrong level of education, teach you discipline, teamwork, and it's also part of education. But the first priority is to have a safe and pleasant learning environment. So we decided that we need, that there's a problem, there's a solution. The solution was to restore this top floor. So in order to restore the top floor, we need to have a strategic plan. The strategic plan, number one, starts with the consent of the principal and the Department of Education. The full evaluation of the top floor, formation of a system group development fund to raise funds and to execute the restoration. Restoration by a highly professional and reputable organization. We immediately knew this was a complex job. It was a tough job that could be done only by a highly skilled and experienced and reputable organization. We then realized that we need to have control of the supplies to get the most cost effective and to keep the supply chain working. And we also decided that we need to monitor the progress of the project for timeliness, for quality, and for cost. So evaluation of the top floor, as you can see from the pictures previously, we have the roof leaks, plaster was falling off, walls were black, dirty and moldy, windows, window sashes were rotted, window panes broken or peeling, electrical wires exposed, fans and lights inoperable, floor concrete cracked and peeling. This was observed in 10 of 11 classrooms and in the corridor. So the first item was to fix the roof. We cannot proceed to the restoration of the floor until the roof was fixed. So we heard from the principal that the money was allocated to the provincial school engineer, but there was a problem. So we had to use some pressure to go through the bureaucracy. And then they follow normal procedures, they call for tenders, tenders were evaluated, and it was awarded in April 2016, and work commenced in August 2016, and that was not due to the fault of the construction company, it was because of rain and the school's rain session. So we cannot do roof repairs, it's a safety issue, until the school's on vacation, but once they started the job, they finished in pretty fast in October 2016. And that's the view of the new roof. And as a matter of fact, I'm aware that 40 million that was for the repair of the whole school roof. This is a view of the site plan of the top floor. There are 11 classes, out of which 10 were in bad shape. The only class that was in good shape that did not get any administrative work was the old form 1C, which is now the shrine room. So I was thinking, why is the shrine room such good shape, but the rest of the 10 classes were really bad? And then I realized that the students of Royal College reflects the society of Sri Lanka. As one Purohit told another, Sri Lanka is God's country, but the devil lives there. So, if you were to use the same analogy, the shrine room was sacred territory, the God's territory, but for generations, the devils ruled, it was the devil's playground in the rest of the 10 classes. And that explains why it was so popular. So, then people went ahead and called for a bill of quantities. This was the estimate they got. Total 29 million. As you all know, if a private organization does it, they want to make a profit. They want to pay for their management, for their staff, for their buildings. 40% probably is for the supplies and equipment. This was beyond our capabilities. We didn't have people like Bill Gates donating us $1 million for philanthropic projects. 60 group could not raise, it was not feasible. So we had to go to Plan B. We all know about Sri Lankan Army. Sri Lankan Army's primary role is the defenders of the nation. All of us appreciate the great job. But during peacetime, the Sri Lankan Army has stepped up to help in community-based projects. We all know they helped in the restoration of the Dharam Thana. So project coordinator, co-vice president Majira, had a formal meeting with Army Commander, previous Army Commander, Lieutenant General Silva, and laid out the case. And he graciously accepted it and ordered the Sri Lankan Army Engineering Services Regiment to commence work. The Sri Lankan Army Engineering Services Regiment commenced work on February 2017, and I have to thank General Mahesh for continuing this project. We all know that General Singh was over royalist, he was biased. But General Senanayake is over Ananda. We love our brothers from Ananda. We highly respect them. But we are so sad that you did not come to Royal. So, with the permission of the Honorable Prime Minister, I hereby appoint you as honorary member of the 1960 alumni group. Honorary member of the 1960 group, General. So you can come and hear some old 60s jokes from us. This is the restorative work going on. You can see all the glass was crumbling. They had to be stripped out to the bricks. Here's an army boys working. This is the timber being cut. We had good timber, take for the window sections, good for the shutter, plastering of walls. This is one of our sites. Here we have Ranjit and Srinath with Tilay Nadesan from Australia, and myself with the office in charge, Captain Mohan Summer Hall. This is another group of 60 members. Everybody who are interested could be visit the site anytime with our team. Here you have Aditya Vijay Sundara and Iran Neil Sekhar, C.D. Sanatandra, along with Mahindra, visiting from UK, our team. Yes, S.F. Fernando practically on a daily visit to make sure that the army was giving everything according to specifications, high quality and good work. This is three of our more prominent supporters, Vyasana, Ajita, and Senator Veerwardhan, who look very, very happy because the PSA is satisfied with the job done, along with our team,
again, Ranjit,
Vasanta Silva, and SL. This is a retired minister. This is a restored classroom. And this is the restored plan, and you can see all rooms are completed. They started from Form 1A and moved out, so that in stages the children moved out. So once those classes were finished, they came back to class. So from about February, the students were occupying the old Form 1A and B, and then we finished with then, which was Form like 2B also, the half so last class. So the work was more or less completed in February for minor touch.
And
the result was accomplished. The 500 students were occupying the refurbished classrooms since February 2018, and grand opening, of course, by the Honorable Prime Minister today with our mission accomplished. We of course want to thank again the Prime Minister, the Principal and staff, Education Ministry, Sri Lankan Army. We did not embark on this project without the support of the Sri Lankan Army. The Sri Lankan 96 Alumni Group, it has been noted that 95% of our total budget was 7.5 million Sri Lankan rupees for this project. 95% came from the alumni. They were people from all over the world. Some of them had not been to the school for 50 years. But the journalists had to do that for two reasons. One, they wanted to give back for the free education received from this country. That was the main reason. Because they are doing well, thanks to the free education they received. And number two, they need the team that was doing the job. We'll complete the job, the task. They had no doubt about it, that they knew who the people are. We have been associated in these people since the age of 10 or 11. In their former years, 18, where it was. They know that the money given will be fixed, the mission was clear, and they knew the task will be completed. We want to thank the only expatriate organization, we did work with the 1962 to raise funds. We thought we can do it from Ottawa tonight. But we had a crash flow problem during the middle of the project. And the New York group, the old boys of New York, racially stepped in to give us 400,000 rupees. Sri Lankan patriot, Mahinda Gunasekara from Toronto, who had been donating to Sri Lankan charities for about 450 years, heard about the project and spontaneously donated money to Hong Kong. We didn't ask him for that. But we really appreciate his donation. And any donation given by it by our students were graciously welcome and was kept highly confidential. So we don't disclose any of that information to anyone. This is the 62 Fund Executive Committee. Myself and Majid are the project coordinators, and we are finally responsible for making any executive decisions. But we had a good team, we were in the same way. You know, Vasanta was our secretary. We had communication liaison with the principal and maintained all our files on communication. We had Jayanta Senanayake, who was our treasurer. Knowing Jayanta as well as I do, I know that the money was safe and he can come for every cent. Assistant treasurer and our cost accountant who kept the supply chain going was Pandit Vikramasinghe. In a complex project like this, all the army had to do was tell SL, we need 10 bags of cement, 20 meters of paper, or 50 gallons of paint. And Rajit made sure he was there the next day. It was so efficient and had the best possible. We had, of course, the project architect, Srilal Fernando, fully qualified architect, who generally donated his time, expertise, and technical skills to maintain the highest standards in the restoration. We are indebted to Srilal. And of course, the project that we did, we had again drafted our constitution and cooperation. Disclosures, we had no conflicts of interest to disclose, none of the 60 group expert committee, either personally or professionally, benefited from this program. There are zero administrative charges. That means everybody freely volunteered their time and their technical skills. All questions and comments, since I don't have to take questions now, should be directed to our project spokesman, Vajra Guruvardhana. In fact, I would like to announce to Kedwarendra, our senior, Sashma Kalvaranchi, and the rest of the other groups, that we have a good team. We are always willing to give you advice and help if you boys want to pick up. That includes SDS, the Royal College Union, if you want to pick up any other project. We have a team ready. We have done the policy procedures. We have the systems ready. We'll be happy to work with you. All you have to do is to contact our channel, and he will is your contact person. And we have to help and activate our team. I want to thank you, and I have to put the podium over the head prefect. Head prefect to the podium, please.
Thank you. 60, where the Honorable Prime Minister is also the member of his group, and the members of Royal College alumni of New York for the project to restore the Royal College West Wing, and to thank also to the Ministry of Education. Thank you.
Students of the current Royal College, we will make sure that we take care of this building and make sure it is passed down to future generations. And I hope the other groups as well will help Royal College in the renovation of the rest of the buildings, because Royal College has a lot of renovation to be done.
My name is Vajira Gunawardena. I'm a member of the 1960 group, which means we joined Royal College in 1960. Many of us came from different schools. Some came from the primary, some came from the St. Thomas's Prep. Obviously, we came to the better school, right? So the 60 group has, we consider group in the sense that we have produced many leaders of the country, including the current Prime Minister, the former leader of the opposition, and also we excelled in sports. We won the Bradby, we won the Gunaratna Trophy, and we won the Royal Tomian all in 1 year. So we consider ourselves a lucky group, but we also consider ourselves to be, want to give back to the school. So we had a big reunion 2 years ago, and we arranged a walkthrough of college, and we met some of our batchmates who were scattered throughout the world after 40 years. When we walked through the school and we went to the classrooms that we first occupied in 1960, we found that compared to the standard of the classrooms we were occupying them, it was in a dismal state. There was mold on the walls. There was broken plaster, the furniture was broken, the windows were broken. So we said, this is not a good environment for the younger generation to learn. So we decided to redo all the classrooms on the top floor of the West Wing. There were 10 classrooms. We harnessed the entire group, we collected funds, and we were able to complete it. And today is the opening ceremony. I have to say that one of the biggest supporters of this project was the Sri Lankan Army, that gave us free labor. And with that input, we said we have to finish this. And today is that glory day for us, where we can deliver 10 classrooms completely refurbished so that future generations of royalists can enjoy. As of now, there are 500 students occupying those 10 classrooms, and for the next, hopefully for the next 30 to 50 years, that these classrooms will be occupied by, in a much cleaner and better environment. The only request I make is that both the students and the young generation maintain these classrooms so that the next generation can enjoy the same benefits that you are enjoying. Thank you very much.